Welcome back to the channel, guys. Today we're testing the Cervelo ZFS-5 GX transmission build. I know you guys probably have heard of Cervelo. They've made road bikes for years. Now they're dabbling in the mountain bike game. I believe they came out last year with a hardtail. Well, I guess 2 years ago, hardtail. And in 23, they came out with two full suspension bikes. Same frame, different travel numbers. I'm on the 120 ZFS-5, so 120 fork, 115 millimeters of travel in the back, and that's what I'm looking for. A nice lightweight zippy bike that I can handle a little chunk here and there. If you follow me on Instagram, you know that I sold my beloved Trek Top Fuel and I'm testing a bunch of short travel rigs. I already tested the Santa Cruz Blair Trail. This bike feels very similar to that. Both Cervelo and Santa Cruz are owned by the same parent company, Pon. So there was rumors that the engineers worked together from Cervelo and Santa Cruz to create this ZFS-5. All right, we got to start a climb to get to the good part. And this Cervelo does not disappoint. The RockShox SID fork and SID Lux Rear Shock provide plenty of support, and just like the Blair Trail and the Epic Evos, it's also got flex day, but this flex day feels a little bit more refined, meaning that it just has better traction on loose climbs and like little baby head rocks when you're climbing, spinning away. This thing kind of hooks up a little bit better. It does have a little bit more aggressive tires than the other bikes I've ridden. It's got the Recons, which are kind of like a hybrid trail slash XC tire, but definitely more traction than the Recon races on the Blur Trail. On my last ride on a Cervelo, which I did without the camera, I did more steeper climbs across the street, and front end stays down on the ground. Really comfortable seating position, about a 75 degree seat tube angle, but man, this thing just mouths up climbs. Really efficient, lightweight, like I said, comfortable seating position. Also, I forgot to say, I'm on a size large today. I'm 5'10", and this thing fits pretty nice. It does come stock with a 50 mil stem, so if I bought this bike, I'd probably go with the 40 mil and put a little rise on the bars, just a touch. Well, I made it to the top and real quick, just pulled over to show you guys the biggest difference between this bike and the Blur Trail is how the rear brake is mounted. This ZFS-5 has a brake mounted on a floating mount, which is mounted right here by the axle, not onto the frame, and on the chainstay on this side, it's mounted. But on the Blur Trail, it's kind of chunky carbon right here and takes up a lot of the frame, this back part of the rear triangle, and it definitely has an uneven feel. These seat stays are very similar looking, so I feel like it has a more consistent ride, and that's how it provides pretty good traction on those climbs. And also the Recon tire is a little bit more beefier than the Recon race. Time to start the good part. Whew. Looks a little slimy today. Oh man. Yo. Nose wheelie. Whew. If you can get your hands on one of these Cervelos, I highly recommend it right now. I believe they're going for like 30% off, like most bikes right now. But there's an XT build. Ooh, not bad. That's like 4,500 bucks, and it's like really nice spec. You can definitely look it up. But man, this thing feels pretty good and stable on the descent. Yo. Yo. This thing's so sketch. Woo. Huck this thing. Yo. Man, this stuff feels pretty good for 4,200 bucks. Sid fork, Sid Luck shock. It's a tiny little shock. Man, it works well. Yo. It's pretty good shit. What's this little guy? Drop? Fuck it. Oh. I am having trouble figuring out which short travel rig I really want. Do I want one of these kind of lightweight downcountry bikes, or kind of like a 130 stump jumper bike, like the regular stump jumper with the flex days? I don't know. I guess it's a good problem to have, right? Phew, this is fun. The cool thing is having these downcountry bikes is that they pedal so well. They feel so light. And this is like a middle of the line build. Feels top end to me. The transmission drivetrain is so quiet. There's no chain slap or anything. Love the Recon tires. It's been a hot minute since I've run Recons. Or ridden Recon tires. So far the Cervelo feels the most trail bikey out of the bunch. Still lightweight, climbs really well, but I feel like the Blur just has a touch more pedal efficiency, and the Epic, you can't touch it. I don't know what sauce they're using in over at Specialized, but that thing climbs like a rocket. But this is definitely the most capable descender, if that makes sense. I haven't tried the new Epic Evo. I'm curious how that compares to this bike, but it's a 120, 130 travel bike with flex day. So we'll see. But the sizing, I looked at the geometry charts. I don't know when I'm going to release this video, if the Epic Evo will be out yet, but I've seen it and it looks like the top tube is a little long for me. This is the biggest I'd go. It's like a 6.18 or something. But let's just finish up our ride with the final descent here. Oh yeah. Woo-hoo-hoo-hoo-hoo. This thing just flies. Yeah, it dances on the trail a little bit nicer than the Blur Trail. Feels more refined. All right, a little Huck's a flat. Yo! That's a little jolting, actually. Let's go left of this huge rut. Ha! Little step up. All right. That concludes our ride on Cervelo. We're right at 14 and a half miles. I gotta climb back. 30 miles total on Cervelo, 30 miles on the Blur, 30 miles on the new Epic, 120, 120. This Cervelo 120, it rips, man. Really fun, light bike. This build right now is going for, I believe, 4,200 bucks, a little over 4,200 bucks. Shannon level bronze brakes. The actual levers feel good, but they spec 160 rotor on the back. That thing is smoking, I could tell already. It's making all sorts of kind of weird noises on the front part of the descent there. Sit suspension, used all the travel, felt pretty good. Clapped it a little bit on that little drop, but I can't say enough about this GX transmission. Thing is dead quiet, really good shifts, a little bit slower than the standard Axis stuff, but I'm enjoying it. But the real nice thing is this one-up dropper. Look at all that. I think that's like 170, 175 mils of drop. Really good dropper. Gets the saddle out of the way, and this saddle, I'd have to change this thing. This thing is like killing my taint. But overall, guys, really solid build for the money, especially right now that it's at a discount. If you can get your hands on like the XT build, comes with Fox suspension and just XT brakes, four pot, and just standard XT shifting, like 12 speed analog shifting. Really good buy for that one. That one's like 4,500 bucks. Comes with the reserve 28 wheels with the 350 hub. So really good wheel set, but really enjoy this bike. Cervelo, good job on the 120 here. Man, if I could find an XT build, or you guys know where I can find one in size large, seems like they're sold out everywhere, let me know in the comments. But guys, I'll catch you on the next one. I'm gonna have to pedal back to the parking lot. Real quick, forgot to talk about the in cable routing here. Goes through the headset. I don't know how you guys feel about that, but you see you guys right there. It looks really clean, but is that a pain about to work on? I don't know. Thanks for watching. Peace.